everyone. Welcome to Survivor Live. This season, we are getting up close and personal with our castaways, and we need your help to do it. So tweet us using hashtag Survivor Live, and we'll bring you into this conversation as we go. Also, be sure to stick around for the exclusive extended preview after this episode. Without further ado, we are joined with our most recent cast off, blindsided and betrayed by her tribe, Sarah. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you.
It's good to have you.
Well, I mean, I wish I could say the same. I mean, I want to talk to you, but I'm not glad I'm here.
Yeah. You went out with quite a blindside last night.
Yeah.
It was a major buildup.
Yeah. Definitely complete 100% blindside. I knew that I had an option of potentially flipping. I didn't really foresee anyone else flipping.
So you did. Like, you were thinking maybe you wanted to flip away from the brains and the tribe that you were on and go back to Tony and the original bronze people?
Yeah, my original plan was to take the three brains and myself over with the three brawn on the new Solana. And
then no one ever talked about that.
Yeah, and after the, you know, top five shout, it was brought to my attention that, okay, well, we're not going along with that plan anymore because that's not gonna work. And
okay, that, so that was when Tony said that after they won the challenge. He was like, top five, top five. That's when your mind changed and you're like, I'm no longer with Tony.
Yeah, I couldn't be because they were gonna leave me in the dust. I mean, we were going to tribal that night and I had to solidify to them that I was going to stay with them. Otherwise, it would have been me going home that night.
The brains people.
Yes.
And this was when, who was
Alexis?
Voted? Alexis was voted out.
Yes. Okay. Because she and Jeffra had an interaction at the challenge where that was enough to make us all uneasy and think that she would flip and go back with them.
Okay, because nobody really knew. Was it going to be Alexis? Was it going to be Jeremiah? But it looked like you were sitting in a good spot, even though you have a bunch of friends on the other side, too. So they should have been threatened by you also.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, I probably would have been more targeted the night that Alexis got voted out if it weren't for the fact that Tony had shouted top five. Because then at that point...
Then
mm-hmm. it was like, okay, now that I'm no longer a part of them, that they've turned their backs on me, I am going to make a new alliance.
Okay. And how long was your feud with Cass going on?
Oh.
When did that start? How did that start? Give us a scoop.
You know, right off the bat, she had made a comment to me that, well, you better hope we win because otherwise you're going home. And I mean, that
when?
Was immediately.
When after the switch up?
No. Or after the swap, yeah. On the first day, we were kind of walking down the beach, and it was just her and I. And I kind of looked at her like, well, why? And she goes, because we can't let you, you know, team up with your... At that time, there were six brawn in the game still.
Mm-hmm.
And so at that point, I had to scramble and come up with the plan of taking the three brains and going with the rest of the brawn at the merge.
Yeah.
And so then when Cliff and Lindsay were voted out, that explains my reaction, is because now it solidified that I was telling the truth to them about us hooking up with Trish, Tony, Wu.
You played, I mean, from my viewpoint, you played a really honest game.
Mm-hmm.
I know that your badge is really important to you, so you were very set on not lying, and if you made a promise on your badge, you kept it.
Sure.
So, like, when Tony came up to you this time, before you were voted out, and you're like trying to decide which way to go, and you're in a really solid position of power, why wouldn't you just be like, okay, I'm with you? You don't have to swear on your badge, but you could say, okay, I'm with you. Were you dead set on not lying the whole game?
No, I did say to him, you know, and you can, it showed on the episode where I go, okay, just let me decide. And he says to me, swear on your badge.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, I can't do that right now.
Right.
So
could you
I
give
was
him a
trying
little
to skate
something?
Around
like
it.
A little something that's like, okay, I'm not going to swear my badge, but I'll give you a little.
He wasn't going to take anything out. He knew that I held that near and dear and I wasn't going to lie if
he
I
was
said
really
that.
Holding that over your head.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
He didn't care. It didn't seem to me like he cared at all about it.
Yeah, he said, I swear on my badge, and then he turns around to the camera and says that doesn't mean anything. So, I mean, it meant something. And to him, does his badge mean something? Absolutely. In the game, did it? No.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something he was willing to put on the line, but I wasn't. It doesn't mean that I'm right or he's right. It just is the way that it was. And it doesn't mean that that makes him a bad cop or I'm a good cop or whatnot. It's the game survivor.
Totally.
And
yeah.
You know what? He's going to get kudos for, hey, you put it all out there and you weren't going to let anything hold you back. And unfortunately, I wasn't able to do the same thing. That was one thing that I guess I wasn't willing to do. And didn't see myself faced with actually when I went into the game.
So you didn't anticipate this, that you would have to lie going into Survivor?
No. I anticipated having to lie, but I didn't anticipate having to put like my job out there like and dishonor my profession. I didn't want to, you know, when
it was hard for you to separate from Sarah in the game of Survivor versus Sarah, a cop, and that's who you are in life.
Absolutely, because I mean, whether we like it or not, whether we're on duty or we're not, we're still perceived as that. And if I go out there and make a fool out of myself, it makes a bad name for police officers. And that was something that, you know, I underestimated actually going into the game, how much that would play a role in my decision making.
Makes sense. All right, well, shall we get some of the fans involved?
Sure.
I think so. Ivan asked, what were your thoughts when Tony and LJ both used their idols and you kept telling them your alliance that you didn't think they had them?
Yeah, I was 110% wrong. I
was like, where did she get that from?
I don't know.
Like, what is she talking about? Why did you think that they didn't have them? You were like, I'm 100% sure they don't have them. What was that?
You know, I think Lindsay kind of said it well in an interview when she said, I underestimated how smart Tony was in the game. I didn't think he could count to 20 with his shoes on, you know. She makes that comment, and it's like, that was kind of how he was playing, but in all reality, I mean, he was playing way smarter than that, so.
He's pretty manipulative, yeah.
So, definitely, I underestimated him going out and finding that, you know.
You just didn't think he was capable of finding it? Or you hadn't seen him, or he wasn't acting suspicious?
He wasn't acting suspicious. I'd been around him for 12 days. I figured I would know, like, at some point it would come out if he had one. So I was pretty sure. I mean, it was like in my season, or the stint that I was on Survivor, I was either spot on or so far off. Like, there was no in between.
It's hard to tell, but he comes out like guns blazing. His Tony's strategy is, it reminds me a lot of Russell. I know I've shared this with you earlier, but he comes out and he sort of just bulldozes his way through people and expects to get his way. And sometimes that works, and it worked with you in the beginning, but then this time it didn't work, because when he told you in the beginning, oh, Lindsay and Cliff are after you, you instantly believed him and were trying to get Cliff and Lindsay out. Was it that this time, after the switch up had happened and then you guys merged, had you had enough time away from him to sort of see through his game, or were you just in a different spot? Like, why didn't you fall for it this time?
I definitely had a chance to like get away, see through his game. Spencer and I got really close out there, and Jeremiah.
That's why Spencer was so mad that Cass turned on you.
Yeah. And so, but I still, ultimately, I wanted to get back to Trish. I wanted to get back to Wu. I wanted to get back to Tony. Unfortunately, that vote was not the time to do it, because, you know, we had kind of made a pact, the six of us, the new Apari, that, okay, if someone flips, and I think it was more intended towards me, because everybody thought that if anyone was going to flip, it'd be me, that you will not get the five jury votes, implying that if you flip, we're going to be picked off one by one.
And was anyone else saying that besides Cass, or was she the only one saying
it? No, everyone was saying it, not just Cass. I don't even know if, I mean, everyone said it.
Okay.
And so, and I was in agreement with it too. I'm like, yeah, you're right. If anyone flips, like, we have to stick to this. This is the only way. And so, that was not the vote to flip for me.
How do you feel about Cass flipping?
I don't think it was the time for her to flip either. I don't see the strategy behind it. She's just made five people mad.
She was sitting in a really solid alliance of three. Mm-hmm. The brains were together, but we heard her say, oh, well, I guess Sarah's her best friend now, and I'm just old news. I guess I'm out of the alliance. Is she just paranoid?
Yeah,
because it doesn't seem very strategic to me either. Seems really emotional.
You know, I think it was an emotional vote because I had the same option to flip, and I just could not see. I came out to win $1 million. Now, if I flipped, could I sit in the final? More than likely, you know, because
someone would want to take you.
Absolutely, you're going to make five people mad. Mm-hmm. So hey, we need to keep her on board.
That's if you can make it to the final too, because now you're a traitor.
I know, but I wasn't willing to then take those chances. I wanted to win the million, and second place and 18th place are the same to me. And I'm not going to sit out there for 39 days, knowing that on day 19 I had no shot at the $1 million.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that Tony has any chance of winning?
You know, yes and no. He's playing a very aggressive game, and it's just going to depend on how he adapts and keeps things under wraps. Maybe LJ's going to perceive him as a threat and say, hey, you need to go. Or maybe Cass flips back.
Cass, it doesn't matter anymore, because this move that she made sending you home was so bad for her game. Mm-hmm. There's no way that she's going to be able to talk anyone into believing that was a strategic move.
Like, yeah.
It was a really bad idea for her to do that.
I agree.
So no chance. But I think that Tony and LJ with their, like, that tribal council was amazing.
Yeah.
Everyone's eyes were bugging out of their heads. Mm-hmm. It was so exciting. And you just didn't know what was going on. You guys are like, oh my God, the other one. As soon as Tony puts the idol on his neck, like, the other one. And he's like, oh, who's that going to be? And him giving the idol to LJ is like, this is my bro.
Yeah.
Kind of a thing. And I see him gaining some favor that way, like really looking loyal to other people, but he has been lying a lot, so that could bite him. Mm-hmm. Also, but now both those boys aren't protected. Uh-huh. So it was actually really great for them to play the idols.
Sure.
And for you guys to be like, oh, the other one, switch it and be voting for Jeffra, and then their idols are gone. But
yeah.
Cass ruined it.
I know. I mean, it would have been it was a roller coaster. It was Tony pulls his idol out. Oh, crap, what do we do? Panic. Luckily, we had plan B, and that was to vote out Jeffra. And then...
Yeah, thank God you had that.
Yeah,
because you didn't want that. You were like, yeah. I'm in charge. I don't want to vote anyone else's way. I'm going to vote my way or the highway. Why? Yeah. Why were you doing that?
You know, I don't know. Because I didn't want my fate in someone else's hands. And you know, looking back, like, maybe it was a little too early to be so stubborn. But, you know, and it wasn't just me. Like, obviously, six people or five people decided, you know, to go that way. And that was inside with me in the vote.
Right.
So it's not that, like, I didn't go up and write their, you know.
But they were all afraid that Tony might have had the idol, which he did.
Yeah, yeah.
And then as soon as that happened, were you just like,
I know,
man,
right?
I'm so stupid.
Yeah. And so then, you know, we vote, and we're like the other one, and I'm feeling pretty confident. Like, I didn't think Tony would play it for himself, you know, because I think it's pretty obvious, okay, if we're saying the other one, we're changing our vote, like,
he'll
probably play for someone else. And he already said it was a community idol.
Yeah.
So then when he played it for LJ, I just wanted to, like, jump up and scream. And then LJ's like, wait a second, Jeff. And I'm like, wait a second, LJ. Like, what are you doing? And he pulls his out. And he's like, oh, I'm going to play this for my man, Tony. And they're like,
why?
I know. It's like,
Dad, no, stop.
And so I just wanted to, like, explode inside. I'm like, this is perfect. But, you know, if I were LJ, I probably would have kept that for myself, thinking, hey, because they don't know Cass is going to flip, because why would they be playing their idols if they did? And so if you were afraid that you're going to lose a number, then you should keep your idol because nobody knows you have it.
It makes no sense for him to play it.
And then you can say that you just found it. Like, hey guys, look what I just found. Like, you can make up a lie or whatever.
And then there's a super top secret idol that nobody even looked for at the merge.
Yeah, right.
What, did you even go look for that?
Yeah, I mean, I didn't have a clue for it. I don't know if someone else had a clue for it. If they did, they
But didn't. Wasn't the clue just like, it's hidden somewhere near your beach, you have to go look for it?
I mean, if that's the clue, then
that's the
yes.
Clue.
If that's the clue. So, no, we definitely looked for it. I mean, people were looking for stuff constantly, even
so
when there was
funny.
Nothing to be found. I mean, Tony had that idol on like day three, mm-hmm. and I looked for idols all day long, every day.
It's
I mean,
an Easter egg hunt.
Oh,
they
yeah.
plant them now, and people have used that tactic of just going to look for them without any clues.
And now they buried them underwater. You know,
yeah, now they're like, this is going to be really challenging.
They're all underwater, so it's not like they're in a tree trunk or whatever. So it definitely wasn't something I was expecting.
I'm really curious about this super top secret, different special power idol.
I am too.
I really want to know what it is.
I do too.
I do think that you're right. LJ like made a really big mistake giving his idol away because he could have just kept it. But I think like there's something about these idols that burn a hole in your pocket mm-hmm. where people feel like they're so excited about them.
Yeah.
They're like, well, I just got to hurry up and use it. You
yeah.
know? Like, it's just fun to play with them
sure.
and surprise other people.
Mm-hmm. And you know what? Maybe he played it too because he's like, oh, but what if they didn't switch their vote? What if they are going to vote Tony? And this could be the game saver because in all reality, if Cass didn't flip and we still had the numbers and they played the idols for the right people, I would have been going home anyway.
Mm-hmm.
It just, like I said, it worked out. So my advice to anyone who plays Survivor in the future is always have a plan B at Tribal and have it like a code word for it and to where you can switch like that because that didn't save me, but it saved us in not looking like fools trying to scramble for a vote.
Together a vote.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good advice.
Yeah.
Were you guys listening to that at home? All right. Jim asks, good job staying true to the badge. Was that your reason for not swearing on it when you weren't sure which way to vote?
Yeah.
Kind of touched on that.
Yeah, I mean, I think we've kind of covered it, but it just, you know, when Tony asked me, if, you know, are you with us? And I said, well, let me decide later. You know, I'm lying to him, and obviously he could tell, and he knew something that I wouldn't lie about is to swear on my badge. And he said, swear on your badge, and I told him I can't do that right now.
Mm-hmm. And then so, he knew you weren't with him.
Yeah, and then that's what
I
knew.
But is that better to just kind of, like, say, oh, you know, I'm undecided, than to play, like, Cass does and Cass comes up to you and she's like, we're gonna vote for you.
No. I mean, I'm sitting here, so I don't know what's better.
That's
you know
true.
What I mean?
That is true. But I don't think like she's not in a good spot now. You know?
I would agree.
But she did the same thing to Jatia. What are you doing?
I know. I think they should have kept Jatia. I think Jatia would have been loyal. And not that Spencer's not, but Spencer and I had a very close relationship and that's what caused some of the rift between Cass and I is because she was
that's why she thought you were so close with Tasha and Spencer and she'd been replaced
because
it didn't make sense to me. I'm like, what, Tasha's having a conversation with mm-hmm. Sarah and now you think you're being replaced? Okay, so you were close with Spencer also.
Yeah, Spencer and Jeremiah and I had made like a final three alliance within our six so, and I think people could tell that us three were close. And so again, it's just, man, I mean, out there you cannot stop playing for a second. You have to manage everything and you have to make everyone feel included. And I guess if I made Cass not feel included or whatever, and that was what made her want to flip, you know, that's on me.
Well, now you've seen the progression of how the game went and watching the brains get like demoralized time after mm-hmm. time in the beginning, and Cass was the outsider there in the beginning. So there's, I think, probably a little bit of that latent resentment left in her at this point, where if she feels like any inclination that she's on the outside, she's going to do something about
mm-hmm.
it.
Yeah.
But you didn't know that. You couldn't have known that.
No, I had no idea because, you know, they told us about, oh, and Jatia, we're so hungry, and I'm making them a big pot of rice, and they're like, oh my gosh, this is more rice we've eaten in one day.
Because they had to eat like one grain
right.
at a day.
So I didn't realize like the dynamic that was over there and what has I mean, you could hear it out of their mouth, but then watching it's a little bit different. Mm-hmm. So
they had it pretty rough in the beginning.
Oh yeah,
and you guys had it great. You were like on Paradise Valley.
Yeah, we didn't have bug bite. I mean, we had a mosquito net, we had pillows, we had blankets, we had two bags of rice. You know, things.
And how much does that help out there? Because it's pretty uncomfortable. You're sleeping in the dirt, mm-hmm. right? And I don't know about you, but I rarely got a good night's sleep. So if you have pillows and blankets.
Yeah.
Does that just change everything?
Oh my gosh, it's insane. Like, the nights were so cold, you know, and I just had a pair of shorts, and so I would get up and have to sit by the fire in the middle of the night. Us girls, like me, Trish and Lindsay, would have to do that because we were cold, you know, and the boys were kind of, they were okay in the night, but so yeah, we didn't sleep well. The bamboo is hard, and then once we get these comfort items, you're warm at night, you know, and the pillows were big, so they were almost like a mat. Mattress in a way,
oh,
you know, and then you have a mosquito net.
That's a huge luxury.
Yeah, and so when your belly's full and you can sleep at night, it does wonders for the morale around the camp. And I think that's what aided in the bronze being so good. And even though it made it look like, you know, even though, yeah, we tried to throw the challenge and whatnot, and it looked divided, we as a bronze team got along pretty well. And
did
we
you
had
really
fun
try
times.
To throw that challenge?
Yeah, we did.
Even after you found out it was a basketball.
Yeah.
Challenge, you
yeah.
still were trying to throw it. I was like, I am gonna kill her. I hate it when people throw challenges. It's like the worst thing for me to watch. I'm like, no, and not for Cliff too, who's just so cute and
yeah.
likable. I was so upset. But then it was a basketball challenge. I was like,
yeah,
he's got
oh yeah,
it.
He killed it. I mean, there was nothing.
You
I mean,
can't.
We could have done nothing. It, like just sat there and said, Cliff, get your own ball, and he still would have.
It would have been fine.
You
yeah.
know?
All right, let's take another fan question. This one is from Paul. Paul asked, Did you suspect that the final vote was from Cass, or did you think it was from someone else? You had the one that voted you out.
You know what? Honestly, it was seriously. It was so much of what just happened. I honestly didn't. Cass and I were not really at each other's throats. Like I think as bad as it seemed. We did get along sometimes, but so
sometimes
I thought that we had mended some fences, but apparently we didn't. And I truly didn't know who flipped. I mean, I didn't process it either. It's all so fast. I mean, I remember just sitting there going, well, how was my name written down six times? We have six people. You know, they have five. How did this just happen? I couldn't even figure out that someone flipped. That's like how in shock I was.
Wow.
And then I could hear people talking amongst themselves as I'm getting my torch. And I'm like, okay, someone flipped because I heard it. And then I go, who flipped? And still didn't, you know. And everybody's looking around
at
each other.
You didn't even realize it was Cass.
And I don't think the rest of the tribe did until they're, not me. And then Tasha's like, Cass, you know. And I'm like, why? Like, why
well,
would you do that? So
she must have been so threatened by you.
I don't know. I mean, I don't know the logic behind it, and I've asked several people if they could rationalize it for me, and so far nobody's come up with how that was a strategic move and beneficial.
I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't get it.
But we definitely saw you. I watched your Ponderosa video when
yeah.
you got back. It was awesome. On CBS.com, you guys can watch those. They're up now because Sarah's the first member of the jury. So you're like, okay, I got to, you know, work this out. You're running on the beach. You're biking. I'm like, what is she doing? Normally on Ponderosa, people just eat their faces off and like
yeah.
sleep. But you're trying to process everything.
Yeah, well, I'm there by myself. Well, I mean, castaway by myself, you
mm-hmm.
know, and so I have no one familiar to me with me, and it's, you know, you come out of the game, and honestly, it's very taxing mentally and emotionally.
Yeah.
So you get out of the game, and it's like you're there with, you know, staff or whatever who can't necessarily relate to what you might be feeling. You know, they get it, but they don't get it. Mm-hmm. And so, it's just, you know, you try to process it and what just happened, and then you're like, then it sinks in that you're out of the game and your chances at winning Survivor are over. Mm. Like, you know, and then, okay, well, this is your home for the next 3 weeks. You know, when you want to go home, and it's so it's definitely like it was. I was using exercise as a form, a way to work that stuff out. That lasted for like 2 days, though, and then I was eating my face off, definitely. And, like by the end of. Before we left, like, my name around there was Fat Sarah because I just, like, ate my face off, so.
That's normally how people process.
Yeah.
After coming off the island.
Yeah.
Cliff said he gained 25 pounds after coming back.
Yeah.
He was, like, starving.
Yeah, I think I came back at, like, 152 pounds or something.
That's amazing. So,
yeah.
It's amazing, too. I mean, even because you're very athletic also. So it's, like, the changes that your body goes through from starving and losing all that weight so quickly, and that your body goes into this starvation mode, so when you do start eating, and the stuff they have at Ponderosa, like French toast, bacon, peanut butter, like, I know people would just walk around with jars of peanut butter just scooping it into their mouths, like, yeah, that doesn't go back on as muscle.
Yeah. Oh, no,
so
no,
then
no.
You have to, like, work really hard.
I would take, like, Hershey's candy bar, like a candy bar, and then put peanut butter on it. Like, peanut butter went on everything. You know, if I ate fruit, it was caked in peanut butter. If it was
like watermelon and peanut butter sandwiches, delish.
So it was definitely like, yeah, you're because you crave those sweets. Like, everyone's been on a diet before where you're like, oh, I'm hungry, but out there when you can only have, I can honestly say I was never really hungry out there. I just craved sweets so bad. Like, it was insane.
Mm-hmm. Because you're going through all that withdrawal, mm-hmm. and your body just wants the sugar for energy, too.
Yeah. So.
All right. Stephanie asks, if you got a chance to play again, what would you do differently?
You know, I don't know if I want to reveal that. Because
you want to play again?
Because I wouldn't want to give anyone a heads up.
Hypothetically, but if you had a chance to go back and you could play again,
I would try to not be so stubborn. That last episode, I was really stubborn, and maybe just take a step back a little bit. I think anyone who plays more than one time can say clearly that their first time they played was their worst. So nobody's gonna sit there and go make the same, like, rookie mistakes that they made.
And, yeah, and you learn a lot after playing.
Yeah, and honestly, I think you can get through the game being honest, but I would say the lie I did tell out there was to Alexis, you know, oh no, we're not going to vote you out, and then we did, you know. So I definitely do feel bad about that, because I did tell her to her face, like, we're not going to.
But that's the thing, that's the game of Survivor, so you have to know when you're stepping into that arena that the rules are different from real life. Like, I hope you're not the same person that you are on Survivor as you are in real life, because you'd be a terrible person.
Right.
Most people would, you know, because the name of the game is to lie, cheat, steal, manipulate, do whatever you can to crush your competition, get rid of them, and move yourself forward. It's very selfish, and, like, you have to kind of play real cutthroat. It's like war, right?
Yeah,
it's a totally
absolutely
different set of rules.
I think you would see a completely different Sarah if I played again.
Okay, so. I would like to see that. I know you got some fire in you because you're a cop and you have some good cop stories, which we're not going to share with you. Sorry. All right, Michael asks, would you play again if given the chance?
Yeah, absolutely.
Everyone's saying that, so it wasn't so bad.
You know, and like I said, honestly, for me, the toughest was the mental and emotional. Like, the weather was that bad, but I knew what it was going to be like. Like, I mean, I've been in the rain before, even just, like, as a patrol officer.
Really?
Been
you
out,
had to, like, sleep in the rain?
Well, not sleep in the rain, but, like, work traffic accidents for a couple hours. You know, stand out there directing traffic for a big accident in the rain or in the snow or in the cold. So, you know, you get acclimated to different types of weather. It's not, I don't work in an office, you know, and then I do a lot of outdoor stuff too, like hunting and fishing, and
oh,
you know,
wow.
So it's not So I'm used to that stuff. So I was prepared for the weather element, and then the not eating. I used to fight MMA, so when I cut weight, that wasn't an issue for me. I only lost 8 pounds on the show. I would drop down to 125. I would lose like 20 pounds when I would
for your competition.
Yeah,
and you're hardcore. MMA is so scary.
So you
gotta teach Jatia. Yeah. MMA fighting.
All right.
She needs help to channel her rage also.
Yeah. But
instead of sabotaging her tribe's rice supply.
Yeah.
Next
I
time.
Didn't know that that was.
Did you teach? Because Trish was teaching Pilates class to you guys. Did you teach any MMA moves to anyone out there?
Yeah. You know what? I think one time Wu and I kind of, he did some martial arts stuff. I did some cop stuff. It was kind of funny. But no, we didn't really beat up on each other out there.
Wu was good in that challenge.
Oh, yeah.
How was that for you, balancing?
You know what? I couldn't even get on the top of that. It was so wobbly. I don't know how anyone could do it. Like, seriously. I mean, you saw all of us. It was like, boom, boom,
yeah.
Boom, boom. And we
went
just
really
all
fast.
Sucked so bad at
it. I was
it.
Surprised that Tony lost it as
right.
long as
yeah.
he did.
Yeah, and then Morgan's up there, you know, holding it down. And it would have been nice to see her stay up on there.
I know. I want to see Morgan make a move.
Yeah.
So now she's like another sitting duck. Like, she just never really has anyone on her side. What did you think about her? She's such an enigma.
Yeah. No, Morgan's awesome.
You like her?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you guys got along out there.
Yeah, definitely. And so I think, you know, we're a duo that you wouldn't necessarily see getting along, you know, mm-hmm. but we just did. And so she's fun and...
Good, I like her. I hope she sticks around.
It looks
around.
Like next episode, she's gonna defend her honor. I know, right?
Yeah.
So I'm excited to see that.
That'll be fun.
You know, I get to hear what happens, but I want to see now. So.
Yeah, well, you'll get to see the aftermath from your blind side because it was a big one.
Yeah.
All right, this is our very last fan question of the day. Who is your bet to win? This is from question mark. I don't know who sent this question in, but thank you.
You know, one person that's surprising me, I was out there and I was seeing it and then now seeing it on television of what's actually going on is Trish.
Oh, you think Trish is going to win?
I think Trish has a very good shot at winning.
I think she's calling the shot.
She is.
Right now.
And I didn't even, I was out there and didn't notice it. That's how good
she is.
That's
pretty good.
Is to be able to call those shots, have no blood on her hands, and, you know, everybody loves her.
Yep.
So.
Yep. And the way that she pulled Cass aside was so smooth. It was
I can't even be mad at her for it, right? Like, she did it in such
real Sandra style.
Yeah. So I'm pulling for Trish.
Okay. That question's from Manny. Thanks, Manny. We just found out. All right. So that's it. We're done.
All right.
Thank you for joining us. Thank you guys for all your great questions. Sarah's great. All right. We'll see you next week. Enjoy this exclusive, extended preview. Bye.
Can anybody go get water?
Morgan can get some water today.
Is Morgan around?
Yeah, she's in her usual spot.
Morgan, no good on the water?
I can get water, but I don't see how, I mean, her saying it in a rude way wants me to go get her water.
Everything I'm going to say to you is going to be in a rude way because you've been being rude to me.
I haven't said anything to you.
Yeah, you have.
Oh my God.
Yeah, but it's not for Cass, the water's for all of us anyway.
I'm fairly certain that Morgan is in a constant state of center of the universe. She's like an old dog. Like, you know, you have like a 14-year-old dog that you're just keeping alive because you love it. You don't mind that it pees on the floor and you have to go feed it, but all it really does is sit there. That's Morgan.
Hey, Morgan, are you going to go or no?
Yeah, she's going to.
Cass, she said that, you know, I'm being really mean to her. I don't think I'm being mean to her. I'm ignoring her. Maybe that's mean, but I think she's been, you know, ignored and made fun of all her life, so she should be used to this.